他可以创造很多工作机会，但是这些工作机会绝对不是给我们的，我们没有机会在那边上班。他甚至可以说，他100%给所有日落公园的居民这些工作，但是到时候我们已经搬走了，这些人可以搬走了。就我，这是我最关心的，我希望的议员可以采取一个立场，就是真正去做一些保护社区的措施。
Thank you. So as I understood the question, the biggest concern right now is about rents that are rising in our community. You all clap. Is that something that is really important to people here today? The rising rents in our community? Raise your hand. I want to hear from you if this is going to be interactive, so I want to see you. If this is a concern of yours, that rising rents in our community. Okay, thank you. Thank you. The question at hand is, how am I going to help protect Sunset Park from rising rents? And there's a bunch of different pieces that you kind of laid out, but that's one of the biggest concerns that I heard you talk about, was how are we going to do that? And the question for us here is, how do we do that right now? What do we have in place right now to protect ourselves from rising rents? Does anybody have any ideas or anything that they are working on right now that they are connected to in programs? Legislation to protect against evictions that are illegal, to bring lawyers to our community, to have access to a lawyer while you're getting evicted, to protect you, to stay in your home. These are programs that are already existing right now, and for any development that's happening in the neighborhood, there's something called the Certificate of No Harassment, more legislation from the city that protects you. If there is harassment from the person who is trying to kick you out, they won't be able to build. They won't be able to construct. These are things and protections that you might not know about right now. And so we need a way to get information out to you so that you know how to protect yourself while you're here in your home. Scree and Dree, has anyone ever heard of those programs? These are other programs where the city can help you pay rent as the rent goes up, if you are a certain age. These are all programs that you should have access to, that you have access to, but you might need more knowledge. You might need more information about how to do that. And so these are ways that we can protect each other and spread the information about our housing issues. There have been ideas that are coming from the community, your neighbors, about how Industry City should be actually funding programs like this, so that you have the ability to stay here in our neighborhood. There's a whole bunch of ideas about how to do that, but that's also connected to making some sort of connection to what they want to change. And that's what we want to talk about as well. How do we bring Industry City, who's already here, they already own the property, they can make the changes that they want with current zoning, which you are already seeing, and they want changes. So let's go to the changes. The changes that, what was your name again? Vincent. That Vincent offered are the following. For us to change the proposal so that they don't build high buildings, to limit their ability to build high, to lower their, can you say it again?
Limit the height.
Limit the height. To the current property. So, how many, well, I guess the first thing I want to say is, we can do that. That idea is possible in this rezoning process. We could, as the city of, council member, myself, working with community, actually modify the proposal to limit the height. And what else, the second idea? About hotels?
Well, you need to, you know, that this restricted the height. It's gonna be okay, but not that tall.
So you're saying it's okay to build hotels, but just not that tall? There are some people that don't want any hotels, by the way. And so, I guess what I'm saying is everyone okay here with building hotels in Sunset Park on the waterfront? Do people have an idea about that, or not tall hotels?
I think we should probably design a hotel, because in the hotel, they do mention that it's...
Can you come up?
They do mention that it's middle income to high income.
So what's the proposal, or what's the... No, for you, for like, what's your idea? What's the idea?
It's not...
Not have a what?
Not have a mid high income hotel.
Not have high or mid income hotel? At all? So, no hotels? I just wanna get, yeah. No hotels. Okay, which is different from his idea, which is just not that tall. So this is where, I guess, this is an opportunity to just kind of talk a little bit about how both of those options are possible with our negotiations with Industry City about changing the application. They are asking to change the zoning. Right now they can't build any hotels. They want permission to build hotels, whatever they want, high-end business hotels. You're saying no high-end or mid hotels. You're saying not that tall. We have the power as a community, through me and my office, to change the application. To say, we will not build this high. And negotiate that with them. And so this is part of the discussion that I want to open up with you about ideas that are important to you. And two ideas that I've come up that you've come up with so far, and I want to get new ideas from everyone else, are protecting people in their homes from high rents. How do we do that? We think we have some ideas on how to do that are coming from the community and housing advocates who are experts at this.
Can you combine your idea and one idea?
Okay, let's go for it. Let's go for it. So what's the new collective idea? Okay, so the limit. Okay, so let's open it up here. This is an open discussion here. What's the discussion here? Because now there's a proposal here to limit the height for the whole campus. Not just hotels, but the whole campus. And no hotels. No luxury hotels. So low budget hotels, yes. Right. Okay. Here's what I do know. So the question is, do I know if we're going to be building low budget hotels? I doubt it. I don't know. And that's not where I have the most power in helping them build a business plan. Because they're a developer. And if you know developers, their number one goal is to make money. They're a business, they want to make money. And so they're going to make as much money as they can, because that's their whole plan. And we know that. And that's just something that's where we start. The question for us here is, how do we think about it in our community needs, and to protect the most vulnerable? And I've heard housing is a big issue, and I'm hearing that hotels and height are an issue as well. Now there's a discussion here about, and then I want to ask others to speak. I don't want you guys to dominate this discussion.
And most water.
So you're mostly worried about retail, what kind of retail?
Fancy retail.
Fancy retail, okay. The unfortunate nature about fancy retail is that we can't dictate through zoning fancy retail. We can't say no fancy retail, right? We can't. But what we can say is the types of use of retail, which right now they don't have all the types of retail that they want to build. Because otherwise they'd be building. They are building there right now. You've been there. They are building there right now. They have some ability to build some retail, but they want big box. They want bigger retail. And we could actually limit their size of retail. And they are already saying they're only going to build 900,000 square feet of property, of retail, to limit the amount of retail. So the question is, can we stop them from building fancy retail? We cannot. Mm-hmm. But we could change the way that they build the kinds of retail on use. And I'm going to, big stores versus smaller stores is probably the best way that we can work with the zoning proposal. Now, I'm going to pause you guys. You guys have been very amazing. And we've been in meetings together, so I want to make sure that we get from everybody else. Are there any other things here that have been of concern to you?
我名字叫张燕克，可以叫我Joy，我住在这边。然后我对工业城计划我有三个问题。第一个关于住房，那很多人因为就是平价屋，那如果说工业城它要开发，那我们很多租金方面肯定会涨。那他们有没有什么计划在我的方这边？他们有没有对我们这边的居民的低收入居民有？ 平价屋的计划，这样子是可以说缓解租金个人的租金的问题，对不对？然后第二个问题。
So the question here is, does Central City have plans for low-income housing on the waterfront? Did everyone hear that question? No. No affordable housing. No housing at all. On the waterfront, zero. That's not their plan. Their plan is to keep it businesses. That's their plan, to change the types of businesses, big businesses, hotels. That's their plan, no affordable housing. That's the answer.
那如果没有平价，那对于工业城，他们这么大的开发商进来，他有交一些税务方面的东西。那很多你也知道，五大道这边我们可以看得到比较萧条，因为工业城那边很大的，像非常大的价格比较高的那些店进来，那造成我们比较小商业这边非常的 depression。 那我的意思是说，他们竟然作为这么大的开发商，在我们日乐公园这边，他们难道？ 就是你们办公室，就是在我们日乐公园的议员，你们不可以说有一个要求，他们应该有一个 funding reserve 在我们这个社区，将来就是 in case 如果有什么关于他们的对于小店，就是小商家那些任何的有将来有问题，可以就是怎么样带领就给。 商家或者住在这边的人，怎么样带领他们有一个过渡的时间，或者 upgrade whatever， training 怎么样让他们的小孩更好的有一个过渡期，不应该有一个 reserve fund 在那边吗？还有另外一个问题，我主要的是对于公共设施，他们这么大，我们这么大的地方的，在这绿绿绿公园的话，对于他们有没有说有一个计划？对于我们在绿绿公园对于公共设施，没有。 He doesn't matter neither. 学校啊, 公园啊, 还有museum这些的建设, 对我们这个地方的建设, 对公共设施的建设, 有什么plan?
一个就业, 一个是那个, public facility.
Can we give Joey a round of applause? Thank you. That's a good question. That's a good question. Okay, I think I got a sense of the questions. The first question was about a fund to help with businesses to upgrade and maybe even potentially bring into Sunset to Industry City so that they can expand and get bigger. At Industry City and maybe on 8th Avenue and to support. How many people like this idea? Is this a good idea for Industry City to put a fund together to support the community? Is that something that people think is a good idea to do? Is this a good idea to ask Industry City, just in concept, about how to get them to support our needs of our small businesses in some way? And the reason I'm asking you to give me some feedback here is that this is ultimately what could happen in this proposal, is that we can ask for changes and resources from Industry City to support businesses, to support renters, like all of you, and build a relationship not just with Industry City, but your next question was about infrastructure, like parks and streets and sidewalks and bike lanes. That just doesn't all come from, can't come from Industry City. That has to come from the City of New York, the Department of Parks, the Economic Development Corporation, the Department for, this is HPD, Housing and Preservation. This is the kind of stuff that we can be asking the City of New York as well, because the City of New York wants to create more jobs across the entire city. We think that we can be asking the City of New York to bring resources here through a negotiation with Industry City. And what I'm hearing from all of you is that you want infrastructure. Those streets, if you've been down there, you probably don't want to go down there because they're in disrepair. You can't walk out there safely. And so part of what we can be thinking about together are the needs, not just from Industry City, but from the City of New York itself. And that's part of what your neighbors have already been talking to me about. And I'm really excited that that's come up here too. That people in our neighborhood have needs, not just from Industry City, but also from the City of New York. A responsibility to the taxpayers, because all of you pay taxes, to bring more resources. Question, there's a question here.
Thank you.
推出来，要时间，时间把这个地方慢慢的变成，而且这里很多有中国人，我们的中国文化很好的，我们就是有特色的，就是中国、美国还有其他四系的，把这个地方变成更有兴趣，让全世界都可以知道的地方。我们要自己的力量是一步步，他们可以借钱我们，我们不要他一天就变成很好，可以这样子吗？
You want to answer the question?
Okay. Can you restate the question?
Okay. 我们的社区不会被伤害，我们社区的民众不会被赶走。如果我们可以留下来，当然我们可以说啊，好像周围要些公共设施啊，我们要一些关键先大家先保住自己的家园，先保住这个小商家。我说对不对？对。要保住再说。我们想要保住呢，就不要让这些开发商去搞一些 豪华的建筑哦，建的一些豪华的hotel，令到我们这边租金爬起来，那个地税涨起来，所以我刚才的建议还是关键点就是限制它的高度，它就不敢乱来，不然的话我们真的租金说飞起来就飞起来了，我们不是这些东西不是我们能够做的，所以我希望我们的议员呢可以帮助我们民众把这个打下来，他已经讲得很清楚了，他不会给我们任何什么低收入房子可负担房屋的。 他们的那些工作机会什么，将来我们被赶走了，跟我们也没有份。他们建的再漂亮，我们没有用的，我们可能要搬走啊，到时候我们搬去柬埔寨啊，或者搬去哪里啊，这个日子永远不是我们的了，好不好？大家保住这个家园，保住这个商家，保住这个社区为主，然后再要求其他东西啊。
没错。
就一个问题，你们之前这里面他的 IC 这个计划里面有提到13000多个就业机会，我就想知道13000多个机会是纯粹的对我们这些绿绿公园的居民开放，还是只是说我们真的不希望我们这些我们这边绿绿公园的人，你们说就业机会有10000多个，但是我们都申请不到。 因为你们不要只是 open 那些 做 hotel，你们开 hotel 只是让我们去清洁工，我们不需要，我们需要非常那个工业城的那些给我们 amendment， 一定要告诉我们多少什么样的就业机会，有给我们什么样的 training， 还有这个 percentage 这个分配是什么样，到底我们要这个 amendment， 不要只是画一个饼啊，我们这里有10000多个就业机会，但是。 对不起，这些什么技术工，你的 technology 都不适合我们，我们只做的只能是清洁工，我们不需要这样子的清洁工的就业，我们需要是有专门有的training的高科技高收入的，因为如果你们在这儿就业的话，不用讲了，租金自然会涨。我希望工业城他们有一个非常 detail 的这方面的东西。
Clap if you like that idea. Yeah? I like that idea too. I like that idea too. For Industry City to have a plan with community to connect jobs and opportunities, not cleaning jobs, but good, high-paying jobs. And I will say this, that there's a lot of discussion about green economy jobs, the jobs that are going to help mitigate climate change. The jobs that are about building the future infrastructure, like wind power, solar power. These are the things that are coming to the city because we've changed laws so that buildings across the entire city have to be upgraded. These are good paying jobs, but they require education.
They require education and training. This cannot just happen overnight. It needs resources. And we need the resources, not just from Industry City, which Joey's saying that they should have a plan and resources. I agree. But it should also come from the city of New York. It should come from the city of New York, who's taking tax dollars from our communities for them to be reinvested into our communities. And so I heard that loud and clear today. Okay, come on up.
其实刚才那个周宇所说的那个问题的话呢，其实你的那个你的教育没到那个程度，有些工作没有这个机会就是没有这个机会。我们必须是提升自己的本身的那个就是说教育，你这个的话才是一个最根本的。你说什么都没用，我们不可能永远都在那个贫穷的地方。说真的哈，我是从深圳过来，当我从深圳来到这边的时候，我第一个印象就是。 纽约怎么那么臭？很多地方真的是那街道真的是很脏。然后的话呢，我们在深圳的时候的话呢，我们走路很快；来到这边的话呢，想走快路的话，真的是还是有点困难。虽然说就是说大家的那个环境教育不一样，你像深圳的话很干净，然后的话绿化很好。我不可能，我们永远就是说日落公园的话，我们不可能的话永远都是现在这样子。 这个条件的话呢，说真的，我们要自身要对自己要有个要求，教育方面一定要跟上。然后另外一个的话呢，我是帮了很多那个就是做生意的，我不知道今天有没有人做生意的在这里，有没有做生意的在这里？
我们也很多都是做生意的，
有很多是吧？因为做生意的在这边很多人给我说的话呢，就说很难请人，因为现在人工已经高了，做护理的人工高了。 变得的话呢，他们会计事务所的话也给我说很难请人，然后那个餐厅也很难请人，就是那就是说大家都很难请人的情况下，再加上这个房租成本很高，那怎么样可以保护小商业者？这个就是说你发展这个的话，我是很支持，说真的，我是很赞同。但是就是说在这个发展这个情况，就是说这个情况下的话呢，我们怎么样可以保护到我们本地的那些？
You want to respond to that? Okay, we could do that. I'm going to let him respond, but I want to hear from other people who might have their own concerns, different concerns, and then we're going to wrap it up in the next 15 minutes.
Okay. 那么到唐人街发现很脏很臭，深圳那边非常的干净，那唐人街那边全部都是中国人，深圳呢也都是中国人，在深圳那边非常干净，在唐人街这边非长得脏，那就是不是中国人的问题，因为街道上很脏，那么政府呢是有很多方法可以进行清理，他们可以加速那些清洁的工作，放点资金资源，很多地方都可以做到。 那么，而且呢，他就说，哦，那些工作机会，大家真的想清楚，我们先真的要保住这个社区，他创造再多的工作机会，可以，只要能保住这个社区，你可以开发，可以做啊，但是不，真的要限制那个高度，不然的话，高楼一出来，整个开发商不单单是一张书记，其他开发商都跑到我们人民公园来建了，而且呢，大家也要明白啊。 这些所谓的工作机会，只是一个根本很空的东西。看看我们社区里面，我们大多数这些移民，很多人都在做餐馆、做衣厂、做这些工作。如果他们创造那些工作机会，真的跟我们并不是非常的接近。我们所以说我为什么我今天跑过来是说，大家先把我们声音发出来。 因为我知道绝大多数在这附近住的都是比较低收入的居民家庭的，很多是四口之家，妇女在家里看小孩，哦，这个丈夫出去工作的，很多情况都是这样的。那么我觉得说，大家关注这个开发那边方面，尽量不要让它豪华发展，保住我们居民社区的居住跟那个小商业。啊，谢谢。
Thank you. How many of you are understanding the translation? Is the translation, can you hear it and understand it? Raise your hand if you can hear it and understand it. Yeah? Okay, good. Thank you. Thank you to the translators. Thank you to the translators. Okay, so here are the themes that I'm hearing so far. No hotels, limit heights, bring resources to support our community on the housing front and small businesses, create job pipelines, connecting jobs for Sunset Park residents at Sunset at Industry City. I'm making it very clear that it's not just the city, Industry City itself, it's the government, the local government of New York that needs to come in with a plan too, to support our parks, to support our streets, to support our businesses as well, and our schools. Are there any other questions or ideas that you want me to hear about, you want me to think about, you want me to understand, besides what we just talked about? Any other ideas or fears that you have? Or things that you like about the proposal? Things that you like about the conversation that we're talking about right now? Let me come over to you. So can I get you a camera?
我就想问，第二个就是，你看沙社怕很大，那工业城呢是在三大要道边，那我们这边大多数的居民是在八大的这边居民有什么比较大的影响？我知道就是说，如果说我就想还问一问你，如果它那边发展的这个工业城，是不是意味着这个房价会高速上涨，地税会高速上涨？那这些发上涨的就会租金上涨就比较近，我们这些人，房东就会加租，然后这些人我们就要搬走。
So this is a question about how far will the impacts be from Industry City, which is on 3rd Avenue. And my thought, my analysis, my information right now is that it's going to impact a very big area. Not just 3rd Avenue, not just 4th, not just 5th. 6th, 7th, and 8th Avenue, I think are going to be impacted. And the impacts are not going to be all bad. I think there could be good impacts to 8th Avenue. If we bring Industry City together with the city and our community to build jobs for the neighborhood so that people can get good jobs, that's a good impact. A bad impact is that nothing happens in terms of the commitment for jobs, one. Two, that we don't find ways to continue to protect residents who are in our homes right now that have and see rising rents. There are tools that exist today and there are tools that can exist tomorrow that Industry City and the City of New York can fund. Those are all things that can be good impacts as well. And so I want you to think about Industry City because you asked for this meeting. You wanted to sit down and hear from me directly because it's going to impact 8th Avenue. And so that's my conclusion, is that it is going to impact 8th Avenue. And businesses and residents have to understand what they can be asking of the city and Industry City together. And that's what I'm trying to do, is to build a larger community coalition that includes both Protect Sunset Park, the community board, local organizations like CPC and BCA. Those are local organizations that should be part of this conversation. They're the ones that do all the daycare, UPK, in our communities, and do senior centers. They should all be at the table, working to make sure that we get all the impacts, good ones, not bad ones. And so, I think it does impact me that way, to be honest. And I think it's so big. I want you to understand what 5 million square feet of property is. It's the size of 2 Freedom Towers. You know that new Freedom Tower in Manhattan that they built after the World Trade Center, Bourbon? It's 2 of those. That's how big of space that we're talking about. 5 plus million square feet of property. So this is going to be a big impact. not just for Sunset Park, but for the whole city. More questions, more ideas. We have a few more minutes, and I want to make sure that I hear from more people here today. New voices. Yes. Why ULURP doesn't work? So the question is, why does ULURP not work? Well, we can spend like an hour on that question. Let me just say this. The way that ULURP works is that it puts the developer at the front of the process. That means that when ULURP can begin 99% of the time, when the developer is ready to go, and that doesn't bring the community in for discussion. And so what we want to do is what we're doing here today, is to figure out what we need in our community, what we are afraid of, and then create a plan to address those issues before a ULURP can begin. And that's why it was so important for us to have this conversation today and the continued conversations that we're going to have about this rezoning and any rezoning in Sunset Park. Because it doesn't include the community until the clock starts. Remember, ULURP, when it begins, it has 7 months to finish, no matter what. The first stop is the community board, and if you've been to the community board, that group of people will decide and vote on whether to support the plan, to reject the plan, or to create some conditions of change. But that's only 30 days, and I don't think that's enough time, which is why we've taken the last 6 months to really think about it with all of you. And all of you have kind of been organizing already, leading to this discussion today. So I think it's about community engagement at the end of the day that just doesn't happen. And what ends up happening during these 7 months is not fact-finding. We don't look for more information. We look to negotiate. The developer wants to get a yes, and the council member and all the elected officials are trying to figure out what to do. And that's a negotiation, which is different from learning, which is different from designing new visions about what can happen in the neighborhood. And that's what we've created so far. And right now, we are not in ULURP. Right now, we have not started the clock. But they want to. And this is why I want to talk to all of you about the things that you want, and I'm hearing clearly about some of them. Come on the 16th. So he's asking me what my position is. Come on the 16th. I'm going to reflect a lot of this back to you on Monday the 16th. Does everybody have that on their calendar? On Monday night at 6 o'clock at Sunset Park High School, I'm going to bring everyone together. And I want you, now that you know a little bit more about rezoning, to come back, because I'm going to report back to everybody about what I've heard. I want you to know that you're not alone in what you feel on rising rents. If you're a small business, on rising rents of small businesses, that you want job opportunities, that you want good education opportunities, that you want the ability to change the zoning application that has been presented by the developer. We have that power. And I want you to know you are not alone. There are other community conversations that I've had that have had very similar requests that you're making here today. So team is passing out flyers for Monday. I want you to bring all your neighbors, because I want to share with you what I have learned with you. Okay, last minute questions. Any last minute questions? Okay, here's a question for everybody. So pay attention really quick. How many people here learned something new that you didn't know before you came into the space? Raise your hand if you learned something new about Industry City. Just raise your hand, I want to say hi. This is an important one. If you learned something new about this process, keep in mind, I want to see it. Because this is beautiful. That's all we wanted to make sure that you learned something new. Even Vincent learned something new. So yeah, did you learn something new today? Maybe. We'll come back to it. Okay. I think we're going to end here. Unless there's any other questions. We're a vibrant immigrant community. Question.
Well, how do you succeed?
So the question is, after the 16th, if everybody doesn't want the rezoning, we could say, we could stop the rezoning. I don't have the power to stop the application. I have the power to tell the developer to stop the application. The developer, that's their application. They can remove it. And they did once in March when I told them, I will vote no on it if you keep moving forward. Give us some time to discuss it. I can't pull it. I can ask them to pull it. And so that will be a possibility for me to do after the 16th. But that has to happen from the developer. The developer can still move forward. Yes, which is the second part. I can't pull the application from the beginning, but if he starts Mueller, I can vote no on the floor of the city council and kill the application. And I've done that before in another project in Redwood. So I have done it before. It has happened. And not many council members have ever done that before. I think I'm like the only one. I'm the only council member that's ever killed a ULUR on the floor of the city council. And I've done it before, last session. And we can do it again. It is possible, absolutely. But thank you for being here. Thank you. Can we give you all a round of applause?
Hi, Mike. How are you?